This is the third video. So what I want to quickly do is taking us again through from where what we've done to this moment before we go further into other two special major sessions that are practical. Now, if you remember, it's about bloggers, money tech training, and we are looking into a way of making money blogging, that your blogging will not just be kind of just doing it, but how to start blogging and how to make money blogging. And that is what this training is all about. And from the first video, we've tried to define blogging as a simple act, simply an act of posting and pushing writing content through website. And I explained that though website is everything online, like your social platform, Facebook and what have you, but those ones are social platform. So bloggers, whatever you post on Facebook is not blogging. Blogging is when you're posting on a general website, a content that you post on general website. And I always like to let, I always says, I think I've explained about it, that the blogging, when I say blogging, we're talking about write-ups. Vlogging is video posting, but blogging is content posting. And then we've talked about who is a blogger, someone who writes. There are people among us who are already bloggers. There are people who are potential bloggers, and who writes for an online journal or website. And then I've talked about the three ways to blog. That number one is training and the enlightening write-ups. You can decide to focus on training, how to do different things and begin to write. You can write on how to cook, how to drive, it's just training, basically. You can train on agriculture. You can write things, you can decide to be writing content that has to do with agriculture, that people will be coming there. You can write about how to grow cucumber, how to grow watermelon, how to tend yam farm or cash crops. You can write different, you can write about Africa, like AfCFTA. Now we're talking about the continental trade zone. You can begin to write about trade zone in Africa, in African countries, or what you can sell in Nigeria, what you can sell in Ghana, what you can sell in Gambia, and the details, information about such, and people read and follow. That's blogging. You can think of different things. You can write about nativity. You can write about villages, you can write about regions, you can write about languages, you can decide to train about anything as long as you know, oh, I'm very good on this. And then enlightening write-ups are maybe write about education. You can write details about health, you can write details about community, you can write details. So those are training and enlightening write-ups. So with that, we have people who we want to read. And then the second one is news reports like Punch, Guardian, any news online, any news house online, or news company. They are, when you say they are bloggers, like the woman, Olunloyo, Linda. So many people, many goes, maybe there are so many that they go into news reports. So news report, they carry news, they repackage, rearrange, just say it in their own understanding, their own time. You can do, you know, there are some things that I've not seen online. BCC came with Pidgin, and this is our own land. I've told us that creativity and innovation is the key for today's business. I'm here to see someone writing news, doing blogging that has to do in Yoruba or in dialects. There are people outside the country who we want to read news in their home language. There is no home language that have less than 1 million people, 1 million speakers. of that language. Just imagine you decide to write news in Yoruba and you have a blog that is Yoruba, Pombili, like Iroyin in Yoruba, and all in Igbo. You're just something unique. Just think about it. It's all about creativity and innovation. And by the time you come up with that, there are people who will be delighted to follow you. You can begin to write about pets. You can write on different things, about sitting down, getting the inspiration, and you build on it. So news reporter, you can write regular news. You just have your ways of presenting it. I remember we've been listening to sport before Brilla FM came, and you just noticed news is news, but the pattern of sport presentation from Brilla FM looks like it's not news, look at another thing. And so many people just delighted in the pattern, in the way of in the rhythm. And before you all knew it, that became the pattern of news report. And today, everybody, when they want to report news, there is a way they broadcast sport news. So you can go in, you can create, sit down, think about it, and something you know that you can write very well. And then the next one is storytelling. Perhaps there are so many dramas. I remember when we were young, Mr. Ali is a trader, and things like, come up with stories. People like stories. People will read you telling stories. Drama. There are those dramas that we normally, those drama books, bring them up, write drama. And Olu said, the way you write drama, people will spend their time reading. Write dramas on marriages, write dramas on the history of lands, write different dramas, and people want to read. Tell stories about tortoise. Tell stories, and it's just surprised that you see people coming to your flooding your page because they want to read. They want to read. We want to read fiction and non-fiction. I know that so many of us, we have this gift. We don't know that, if I sit down, do you know that you can just sit down at home and build this venture and it becomes explode? Who would ever thought that Mark Angel just with a video, and today see how many skit comedians online, and many of them within months they are making money. Anything can make money online, anything, because it's all about numbers. It's not about numbers. As long as people can be able to accept what you are doing, they enjoy what you are doing, they can share, they can call someone to be part of it, then you will definitely blow. Say that as they say. So all I'm just trying to say is that you can become a storyteller, you can write it, you write drama. I get your cast. I remember then we read from that some that some of the magazines we read then. That's some of the magazines, even the regular Wale Adenuga magazines of those days. You read stories, so you can come up with stories like that, and different stories, events that happens. Things that happen, that's about fiction or non-fiction, come up with all this. And before you know it, you will have people following you. I gave us the examples of some of the bloggers who are making money in Nigeria, who have names. And of course, Jidenwo, people like Linda KG, Javet Omojua, that was used for Buhari in 2015 to win election. And Jude Audi, if you understand that, and then Kenneth Wadi, Kemi Omolulu, she's always in news. And there's, of course, I only mention names about bloggers. There are companies as well. There are companies that, like, whatever, what you see, so many companies today, even they punch the people, the companies like Guardian, what they are doing is that they are blogging. What they are doing is the legit and many like that. What they do is they blog. This blogging, so we call blogging. They go for story. The BCC, Nigeria, they have African news and many like that is blogging. What they are doing is that they are blogging. Sarah News blogging, these are, and they are making it from from that. So, and I remember I talked about that. So it's not just, it's not limited. You can make, you can brand your company as a blogging company like Sahara News, like Punch, or you, it can be personal. So, and of course, all these people have become institutions. So, and then I now talked about the four ways that you can make money. I talked about four of them, that on your blog page, you can decide to sell your own product. You can choose your own product to sell on your blog page. And so I explained to the two ways that we're going to do the practicals for those who want to have your website. And then the two ways, the first one is that why do you write your stories? You give, for example, if you are talking about ulcer, you now talk about food, the foods that all people with ulcer should take, and you now get to a point, and you have, probably you have smoothie for ulcer people. So you just write about it, you mention the name and why you talk, and that if they need, they can get from you, that you sell it or you introduce it. And that's one way. Or another one is by banner, so a graphical presentation. There is a way we slot it in that when they click, it takes them to where they can buy, where they can purchase that, or maybe WhatsApp, that they can take the conversation further. So you can sell your own product as a blogger. The second one is that you can sell product for other people. It's, you see, one thing along with creativity and innovation is boldness, to the boldness to go out and talk to people. See, the markets are waiting for you at Alaba. The truth is that there are so many people, they are distributors, American product, Japan, this brand product that they are making money staying at the shop selling, but they have not ventured into making money online. That's the opportunity. You can meet someone who drives in Alaba and agree on commission with the person. So, and the interesting is that you have the pictures of all the products. And when you go online, you type, you can always get those product pictures and you push them. And when there is a customer, you make the transaction, any way it goes, either by online or delivery or whichever way, you make your commission. Do you know that you can sell for furniture for companies? All you just have to do is to go to furniture companies and let them know that you're coming from an internet blogging companies, and you agree with them that they will be giving you pictures when they finish every furniture job works, when they finish already in their showroom, agree the price, they will give you your own percentage, and you promote it on your platform. When you sell, when people order, when you sell, you make your money. And I said, you can be selling auto, you can selling automobile. It's just going to auto shops, agree with them on percentage. Then I give you the commission to give you. And then before you know it, you're selling. You can sell cloth in block. You can sell first grade cloth with these guys in there that sell. You can sell first grade bills. It's all about agree on commission and when there is order, and you sell. And then I talked about, and I said that again, for some product, even if you don't have product now, you can start some product and just have a way around it. Then I talked about affiliate, and I said affiliate can be for handy product, and it can be for virtual for a downloadable product. So it doesn't have to be, it can be virtual, it can be handy. So just agree on the way you're going to do the process, or just they agree. There are so many companies online that they do affiliate. I talked about EAP affiliate. For some of us, you stay, what I encourage is that look for the group Empower Africa Project on Facebook, because all our information is always good there. So when we are starting, when we'll be starting the EAP affiliate, so you can be able to part of it. Or like EAP affiliate, we have a marketplace. And Empower Africa Project creates a marketplace, and we don't want to sell direct to buyers. We want to sell through, we want to use that medium again to empower people that, okay, you can come there, sign up as an affiliate, you pick product, you will sell, and you're entitled to 50 to 75% profit. It's profit sharing. Because what we do is that when they place order for that product, we deliver, and we agree that you pay your own and things like that. So we have EAP affiliate, and there are so many companies that have affiliate that you can drop the link on your blog page, and you will explode because the people don't do place order, and you make your money. And this doesn't cost you. You see, the interest is once you have your website, you can be doing other businesses, writing, you find out the time you write, and you put the link. And it doesn't stop you doing other jobs. It's all about creating, timing yourself, working things out. So you'll be doing, you are creating multiple streams of income. And the interesting thing is about blog is that once you have a post, you have it. Just push, the post is online, people will always read and your money will always come. That's the interesting thing. And then the number four is about subscription. It adds subscription on Google, and I talked about Hard Naira, if you remember. So I need us to watch those videos to really know about all this, because now my plan is that, like the Hard Naira, I remember I talked about the Google AdSense and how to sign up with Google AdSense. You have it that the way that Google paid back on blogs, they have the AdSense for YouTube, but we are talking about blog here, and this is they have the way they pay back on this. And I talk about Hard Naira. I remember I shared the link, I'll see you have the link. The Hard Naira is an indigenous company where you can place, you can drop your blog page. You make your blog page available as a publisher. So when people bring adverts to Hard Naira, Hard Naira drop adverts on your blog, and you share newspaper when they click and things like that. You make money doing that. And the difference between Google may not allow some of your product advert. At some time, they rejected some. There's some blog they reject, there's some blog page they reject. But for Hard Naira is more flexible. You can sell on the same post, you can sell your own product, and at the same time, Hard Naira can put their advert on your blog page. So it's interesting that you make money via Hard Naira, and you still make money selling your product. For example, you talk about health and you say you can do this, you can provide this. Now people read the article, they see other products they buy, and then you still make money. And don't forget, I talked about the strength of a product that goes along with the article, with the content, that they have the 75-80% advantage. Because if I'm reading about hypertension and I just see a product that cure hypertension, I'll be tempted to click on that product than a product that talks about education, because what they focus there is about health. Right, so things around health will have more. It's not that other links will not sell. Of course, other links have been selling, but we're talking about the one of advantage. For example, I'm reading about education, children education, and I see a bank talking about saving for children, schools, or anything that has to do, or maybe a school is available. And now you now see another advert for honey. Before my mind will shift into buying honey, it will be somehow, but my mind will be focusing more on things that has to do with education. So that's what I'm trying to talk about. But these are not limitation, but it's just about the strength of, we have to know in building funnel, the demography I talked about, it's the demography. This is how demography is being set in by what's the behavior of who is buying this product, what is their interest, what they want to know, where do they gather, if they come online, which pages do they go to, what is interest them. So if someone wants to read about education, that is a product that has to do with education will interest me more than a product about health. But if it's health I want to talk about, if the product around health will interest me more. Okay, I'm about to retire and I'm looking for, if I'm reading about investment, retirement. Now, the product that has to do with either fixed up investment will interest me more than any other thing. So this is the way it works. So I want us to go over all those videos. Because the next stage we are going to, I want to be talking about our tools. And so in the next video, I'll be talking about the tools that we need for for us to really achieve this. So I really need you to go through all the videos, watch the videos, write down your questions, and write the questions so that you're able to drop them, be able to ask, and I'll be able to provide answers to them. So what you do for me, it's for us to always know the next thing. The video, when you get to the YouTube page, please subscribe to the YouTube page. When you subscribe, you have updates of other videos that have different trainings that are coming up. And then remember to, when you get to Facebook, to look for the group Empower Africa Project. When there is a page, you like the page, but the Empower Africa Project group, when you add, when you join the group, it's easier because all the information ends, because we're having larger, now we've had like almost 100 different groups. So it's becoming larger for us to really handle, and because of so many things. But if you come to that Facebook group, you have all the information that we need to pass across, and you can be able to follow and be able to get more. So please do this. I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.